Hello, this is Stephen White from SteveArts89. Last night, the real trailer for The Dark Crystal dropped, and I want to do a little video. I want to do a reaction, but unfortunately, I have a cold, and that's why Fizzgig is here instead, because I look like hell. And I wanted to do a reaction shot, like a reaction video, because I love watching other people do reaction videos where they basically look like idiots and react like little children when they're excited about something, but it wouldn't be pretty. So we've just got Fizzgig today. So yes, it dropped last night, and I was gonna watch it and I was like, no, go to bed. So many things happen like this in Australia. We get it late at night and I have to wait till the next morning, otherwise I'll be up all night analyzing it or getting excited or being angry about it if it's something Star Trek related or Star Wars related. Or but The Dark Crystal is not that. The Dark Crystal, they actually seem to have a clue what they're doing. They actually are honoring the original, replicating the world correctly, exactly, beautifully. The backgrounds, the whole world, everything from the preview looks like the original Dark Crystal, which shouldn't be a surprise, which shouldn't be a relief. But with all the crap we've gone through with Star Wars and Doctor Who and Star Trek and now Game of Thrones, which really shook up the normies. And the regular people who didn't seem to get what was happening with a lot of the other programs. But the Dark Crystal does not seem to be affected by any of that. It's got everything seems right from the preview, the original atmosphere, the darkness, the beauty, the lightness, the joy, everything, the balance of that, which is what was so great about the original movie. It wasn't just a little kiddie fairy tale. Was all sweet and pretty. It was dark and scary at the same time, and that's kind of what the real world is like. And that was one of the great things about 80s films. They actually gave you a little bit of reality in that fantasy. Unlike new films where every I'm not even going to go about modern kids films. Thank God I'm not a kid and I don't have to grow up with them. But Dark Crystal, yes, amazing, great. There's actually some action. We actually see now a lot of things which now they've said it's all puppetry. And it may be 90% puppetry, but there's some. They said there's no CGI, as in no actual created beings or places. In theory, everything is either a miniature or practically built. But there are some scenes which are a bit too big. They have to be using more extensive special effects than just green puppetry lines and people in green suits moving things around. Just removing that. They have to be doing more than that. But I get that they don't want the idea that this is, oh, it's just CGI. They want to make it really clear we've used real puppets and ignore the fact they've used some augmentation with CGI in that. I'm sure they have, but it's so minimal and it just adds just that little extra dimension, which the original film did have. They used matte shots and very big sets, and they had a lot of scenes of, like little figures running along large landscapes and stuff like that, and real practical figures on in they did a good job of that, and they've recreated that, and I'm sure they've done it mostly practical. So I was just so excited. I got chills and chills and chills on top of chills because it looked so great and it captured the feeling of the original movie and what I experienced as a kid. Now, when I was a kid, I didn't see the film on the big screen. I saw it late on TV and then video, and later I got it on Blu-ray. But this is all I had when I was growing up of the Dark Crystal. I had this freaking book, which I read over and over again 1,000 times. I would just stare at the artwork, which I thought was amazing because it looked just like the film. So this was my Dark Crystal. This is all I had. This in my imagination to create that world. And then I go out in the backyard and try and build the world in my backyard. And, like, yeah, I remember having toys stuck in vines. And I'm just glad that I had that as a kid, that it inspired me and it was what it was. And I probably sound awful because of my cold, but it's coming out on August 30, and go back to Fizzgig so he can tell you all the news. Yeah, August 30 is coming out, and that's really all we know. There's Helena Bonham Carter, Helen Bonham Carter, I can't pronounce her freaking name, and Mark Hamill are two of the people doing voices, which I was surprised to see they actually had some stars, but I guess it makes perfect sense. It's Netflix, they've got money. But it's not about the stars, not really about the voices anyway. I'm curious who they're playing. And there's a few other names I recognise, very important people, apparently, but I don't really care about any of them. So when they have the final list of the cast, I'll read through it all when I do a bit more extensive look at the series. But yeah, it was great. See it. See the preview. Get excited. I think it's okay to get excited now. After all, so many franchises have gone down in flames in the last 5, 10 years. The Dark Crystal is not one of them. It looks like it's going to soar. It looks like it's going to be amazing. I don't see how they could fuck it up too badly. I really, at this point, I don't see how they could ruin it. Even if the story isn't great or the characters, we don't love them as much as the originals. Just going back into that world and having that look and that reality back, because I don't know, it's so strange. It's like I said, the world for me lived in that book and later the film itself, rewatching that in my imagination. Now the idea that there's actually going to be a whole series of episodes to watch as well, that it's really being expanded and added onto, and there are a few things that have been expanded and added onto. Only a few of them have been done well, so you can actually enjoy them as a fan. But this looks like a direct continuation of that universe, and I'm really happy and excited about it, and I haven't been happy or excited for anything for a while. Twin Peaks, I was ecstatic about when that was coming back. I watched the series every weekend for like a month in a row, marathoning it just to get ready for the new season. And it turned out to be a 18-hour David Lynch film that had very little resemblance to the actual relation to the actual series. So that was incredibly disappointing. Then Star Trek Discovery came out, and that was the antithesis of Star Trek. It was dark, it was nihilistic, it was just everything that was wrong it could be. Star Wars didn't affect me as much because it was, I just wasn't as attached to it, but then later through fans and I realised all the things they did there. So there's a lot of franchises, and Doctor Who, I've heard bad things about Doctor Who, but I haven't seen it, and I don't know if any of that is true, or if it, because there's a bit of a gap between the toxic fans and toxic studios and working out what's real, and I haven't worked that one out. I know what's real about Star Trek and Star Wars. Doctor Who, I haven't sorted out. So after all those shows, all the disappointment with those, and all the heartbreak with those shows, of sitting there thinking, these things I love are gone, and instead of being able to revisit them and enjoy them, I've got all I have left is my mementos because there's nothing new coming from them ever. So if that had happened with The Dark Crystal, all I'd have is my couple of DVDs and my lunchbox and my couple of books, which is all I've got at the moment. I need to buy more merchandise. I forgot about my comic books. I bought a few other comic books, but that's it. So the universe is very. That giant universe is a little small so far as my merchandise, and I'm looking forward to expanding it and giving Netflix and the Jim Henson Company lots and lots of money. Why? Because they're actually giving me something, and they actually care about the fans and their experience and what they're giving us, unlike some of the other franchises which I have given no money to. I've bought no merchandise for years because there's been nothing I've been wanting to buy anything for. So I'm looking forward to this. I'm probably going to review every part, every step of it, and every episode, and hopefully it's great. Hopefully, I can't see it being too kiddy. I can't see it subverting our expectations and being some gender politicky, overly intellectualized, over talky. I can't see it diverging from the actual original movie. So I'm pretty excited. And I don't know what else to say other than that I'm really effing excited. Oh, and I also found the original comic book. I found the individual comics, which looked awful, and then I found this nice special collected edition, which had much better printed pages. So that's my little Dark Crystal collection, which will grow. And I should do some videos on some of my toys and collections, and that's something I love seeing other people do. But okay, I'm running out of shit to say. Just that it was awesome. I love it. I'm gonna leave it at 10 minutes because that's long enough to just praise something that looks good. And Fizzgig has done a very good job of narrating my little video, because I look awful because I have a cold and I probably sound like it too. But thanks for listening. I hope you all are as excited about. I hope everyone is excited about this as I am, and it looks from some of the videos, reaction videos I've watched, that everyone else is excited too, because aside from Cobra Kai, and I never really got into The Karate Kid, that's apparently the only other show that seems to be honouring the original and giving fans fan service, as well as just being a good show for new people to enjoy. And hopefully The Dark Crystal is going to be the second one. And apparently the Godzilla movie is looking good, the sequel, which I'm going to see on Saturday, so I'll do a video for that, I guess. That's looking good as well. I wasn't a huge Godzilla fan, but I liked the film before this, and I get that the fans are excited because it's staying true, it's expanding on the originals, but staying true to them and honouring them and giving fan service as well as being its own entity, so that's looking good too, and I'm going to pay some attention to that. So we've got a few franchises now which seem to be on track, and hopefully the others will get back on, so I can be making excited videos like this about future Star Trek products or future Star Wars films, or hopefully. So thanks for listening. I just am relieved. I don't know what I am more, excited or relieved. Excited because I really want to watch this show, or relieved because it looks good and I don't have to deal with more subverted expectations and disappointment. I'm so glad. Okay, thanks. Feel free to like or subscribe. I'm going to try and have some better content in the near future and do a bit more work on this series as it develops. Thanks, bye.